Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the future of the past, which is still the past for you. Meaning, I record episode 11 after episode 12. The reason is, I fucked up the first recording of episode 11. Aren't I great? Now, the first recording of episode 11 basically was me rambling about what may or may not be in the not summer season. Basically, what games I have in mind for that. Which are a lot. And I actually have a fair amount of round table games in this regard. Which pleases me greatly. And I have one hell of a forest here right now. And I have air in my stomach. That's great too. And mouse, please behave. So, what games do I have in mind for the round table? And yes, I actually made me a list. I just want to be sure, and this list is not, thank you mouse, isn't by all means not even slightly filled, because I have games, a lot. So, first round table, they have, for example, Shovel Knight. Basically means Shovel Knight, Plague of Shadows, and soon Spectre Knight and King Knight. So that's that. Then I have Don't Starve, which will probably be like this format right here. I may actually do Don't Starve exclusively summer, because that too is a rather light game. And I know you all want to watch me die in horrible, horrible ways, because you are horrible, horrible people. Just like me in this regard. Malicious joy for the win, right? Then there's the Darkest Dungeon. And there will be a rule set for me, gameplay-wise. I will pick my subscribers. I will name fighters after them. And once you are named, or basically conscripted, and you die, you are dead. No second chances, no revives. None whatsoever. Which basically means I will cry. Every time someone of you dies. And I will do my best to not let you die. Then there's XCOM Enemy Within. Which basically is the same rule set. You die, you die. And I will do my very best to not let you die. Which can, of course, backfire. Depends how annoying you are. If you don't get the class you wish you wished for, because you didn't comment your class, or it's just not feasible at the moment, then you are stuck with what you got. And it doesn't do anyone any good if you are complaining about it. Just so you know. Just so you know. Then we have Valkyria Chronicles. I can already hear the people shouting, "That's a story-driven game!" I know. But it's not role-playing immersive. Let it put me like that. I would shout a lot at Welkin and Co. because I've got to say, stupid. More. Yay, let's be over optimistic. I can be very optimistic. You saw it in the grim epilogue of my Dark Souls playthrough. With a dead friend and a trodden down Fiery. It was a sight to behold. And I actually don't want to repeat that particular adventure. It was fun, but it was grim as all hell. We actually had to say, during the break, "Friends, go to bed." And my promise, go to bed, dude. What I said. You kept your promise, for crying out loud. It's geschlafen. Okay, thank you. Bye. Really, his last words are almost unrecognizable. He was so tired and mumbling. And all that because of tea talk. Poor man. Love and masochism. Love and masochism. Back to games. Next on the list for the round table is Mark of the Ninja. 2D stealth. I put it there because points. It has a ranking system, it has points, and it is actually a big deal, that game. Granted, you are a mute protagonist with its own share of woes, but I would still put it on the round table. Maybe you can talk ninja for a while. That would be nice. Let's talk ninja then. Next thing is, again, Salt and Sanctuary. I want to revisit this game on this channel, because I love it. Granted, I'm still in the honeymoon phase. I'm deeply in the honeymoon phase. But I love it. I love it to bits. It's awesome. Buy it. Yada, 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 yada. Enough advertisement. Back to the list. And there's something special. Never Alone. Kishima Ingichuna. Still very story-driven, true. And it is a co-op game. One of the few co-op games I actually own. Except, for example, Dark Souls. And Left 4 Dead 2, because there was once a time where it was free for all. And I still have it. It's a special little thing because it is a world game, a world educational game, something along those lines. And I actually tried to play it before my PC said, "No, I'm too warm! I'm dead! Sorry! It's too warm!" It actually was captivating. And interesting. The art style is pretty cute, actually. Except for the main villain, but hey. He's a villain. He's not supposed to be cute. And if he was, I would shoot myself, probably. Oh, he's so cute. Where's the shotgun? Something according to those lines. And yes, there's still Plants vs. Zombies 1, Season 2 of my adventure there. And then something that I didn't write down. Ziggurat, Sunless Sea, Desktop Dungeons, that kind of thing. I have that too. So that is for the round table. Cast your vote down in the comments for the coming months of the autumn, winter and spring. Cast down your vote. Because those are the games I have. If you cast down a vote for a game that is not on this list, even though you know that I have it, consider your vote void. Because you have no way of actually knowing, except I say so. I say all of my game library right here or to you. You have no way of actually knowing that I have the game. So, yes. Next. Let me flip the list for the Fireplace. There we have Shadowrun Returns, Dragonfall, and Hong Kong. Shadowrun Returns is probably the shortest of the games, and I'll be honest here, the one I want to do the least, because Hong Kong and Dragonfall are way more interesting. Way more interesting. And no, you can't say all three of them, you have to choose between one of them. You have to choose. Luckily those games can be done in no particular order, says a man who suddenly heard baby zombies. Jesus flipping Christ. You heard that too, right? Somewhere down there. I have to block it off. I really need to block it off. Where was I, Shadowrun? One vote for one of the titles. And you have only one vote per format. So you have one vote for the round table and one vote for the fireplace. Anything beyond that is out of your jurisdiction. Jesus. Stop your groaning down there. So, back to the games. Jesus. No, we don't have a Jesus game. Let's go further on the list. Call of Juarez Gunslinger. Yes, it's Ubisoft, and yes, it's one of the better Ubisoft games. The fun. Oh, this game is fun. Nice gunplay. I normally go, actually, Desperado aka Revolver Held. But hey. I like the revolvers in this game. It's either that or actual rifle. School shotgun. Then we have Transistor. Another beautiful super giant game. Still didn't complete it, and I probably won't until I actually record it. So if you spoil me past a certain point, basically 5 minutes after the spine, I will hunt you down and smash you to bits. Next we have F.E.A.R and F.E.A.R 2. And again, one vote for one title, and you only have one vote for the fireplace. So choose wisely. It is a horror FPS. I might fall into the same trap as Dead Space, but I'm willing to risk it for this biscuit. Then we have Darkness Within. Something more like Amnesia, I suppose. I don't know a lot of it or about it, so screaming will be abound. You have been warned. I'm not too shy to scream if need be. Oh, Jesus. It's really getting dark. So yeah, if I scream, I scream. It happens. Didn't happen in Dead Space. Didn't happen in The Last Door. The Last Door was more creepy horror than anything. And Dead Space, as I said, it's action. It's an action game with horror elements. And it didn't use said horror elements particularly well. But enough of that. Now, Call of Cthulhu. The exactly same niche as The Last Door. Because The Last Door leans heavily on the Cthulhu mythos. The two games I have from Call of Cthulhu are, and I actually wrote it down, Prisoner of Ice and Shadow of the Comet. Again, we have one vote and you have to choose one title. Prisoner of Ice or Shadow of the Comet. You have to decide between those two if you want to vote for Call of Cthulhu. There's no way around that. Then we have New Vegas, which will probably then follow me for years to come. One reason, mods, other reason. It is already a pretty long game itself. And that would be the one project on my channel where I wouldn't say Fireplace and then name of the game and the part. That would be more like Chapter 1 New Vegas part. No. Or Chapter 2, no, so on and so forth. It would follow that format. It will be still under the Fireplace. But each chapter would have its own playlist. Which would also probably mean that I will put the whole playlist, all the playlists of New Vegas, into a separate corner on the channel. Because it will be huge. It will. I'm a fast player in some regards, but there, I will make a character, I will make a story. And if you get angry at me for deciding certain things, remember, the character has decided, not me. Please fire your complaints towards the character, not the player. Then we have Fallout 1 and 2. Here again, one title. You have to choose, and choose wisely with your vote. These games probably won't be in chapters, mainly because they are most likely shorter. Say most likely. And then 200 episodes later, I'm still on it. I would pretty beefed that would be the case. But hey, shit happens, right? Then there's Underrail, which I would say is a clone of the first Fallout. And that is okay, because it is also a pretty nice game and it doesn't completely rip off the first Fallout games. Then we have Dust in Elysian Tale. For now, it is in the Fireplace list. Can later on switch that if I so choose. Because it is Metroidvania as far as I can see. And on the other hand, screw the first boss. You have to parry on parrying and this game is a pain in the behind. But hey, it's here. And I would say it's actually really, really good. Yes, it's furry, but hey. We all watched Sonic the Hedgehog. And anime and what not. We're already corrupt in that regard. And then there's Bioshock 1 and 2. I don't own Infinite, and as of this recording, I know that it is on sale during the Steam Summer Sale. Money. And I know me, I would go for Bioshock Infinite and at least a season pass, because I wanted DLCs too. I want it complete. And for that 14 euros, if I would have this money, I would buy it. And most likely directly install it. It's also a game I could most likely run on high or ultra and record. Barely, but hey, it would be possible. So, those are the games. There may be a few more in the future. For example, Crusader Kings. But for Crusader Kings, or to be more precise, Crusader Kings 2. I won 2, but I'm talking 2 right now. Crusader Kings 2. For that I would need at least another one more monitor. Because Wikipedia links. Let's learn about the Crusade and its participants. Yes, indeed. Wouldn't that be nice if I could do that? But for that I would also need a PC with a lot more beef. Not this old one, which is going to be 7 or 8 years old soonish. It hold up very well. I have to say that. What else can I add to the fireplace on the top of my head? I would like to do Skyrim, but I know that I don't have the power for it right now. Especially once Skyrim Special Edition comes out. That will need more power. A lot more power. Because it has a medium size or medium range ENB already installed. It will also be more powerful because 64-bit, but yeah. You know, I need more power for that. A lot more power. And if I really want to do Skyrim, I would actually wait for the special edition. And save more power. More powerful mods. B, a Skyrim that actually could use more than 3 gigabyte RAM and some change. So on and so forth. Looking nicer, having pretty shadows by default. Because Skyrim, quote unquote vanilla soon, has atrocious shadows. You want nice shadows? Put an EMB on. It's bad. Shadow striping, so on and so forth. Why do you think 90% of the Let's Players are using EMB? A, because it looks nice. B, the shadows. It's the shadows. It's always the shadows. And there are pretty subtle ENBs out there for Skyrim. So, anything else? I still have to decide where to put Sangford. Because that's a game I want to play again as well. And if I want to play it, then I can put it on the channel. I will still have my fair share of games I play in private. So in Sanctuary right now, for example. Oh, Diablo 3! Yes, I can play Diablo 3 again. That's awesome. The flipping desert can kiss my ass. It's great. It feels amazing. Yes, I still have stutters and the connection is not the best, but hey. Nothing new there for me. Nothing new there for me. Oops. So yeah. That's basically the lineup. Oops. So here are the rules again. We have two votes. One for the round table, one for the fireplace. And here are the games again. For the round table, Shovel Knight, Don't Starve, Darkest Dungeon, XCOM Enemy Within, Valkyria Chronicles, Mark of the Ninja, Salt and Sanctuary, Never Alone, Kishima in Gichu. Again, Never Alone, Kishima in Kichuna, Plants vs. Zombies 1, Ziggurat, Sunless Sea, Desktop Dungeons, addition to this list, Faster Than Light, FTL. That was a round table. Now the fireplace. Shadowrun Returns. Shadowrun Dragonfall. Shadowrun Hong Kong. Call of Juarez Gunslinger. F.E.A.R. F.E.A.R. 2. Darkness Within. In Pursuit of Loath. Darkness Within 1. So. Call of Cthulhu. Prisoner of Ice. Call of Cthulhu. Shadow of the Comet. New Vegas. Fallout 1. Fallout 2. Underrail. Dust and Elysian Tale. Bioshock 1. Bioshock 2. Those are the games. Those are your choices. Choose wisely and cast your vote down in the comments. And again, if you vote for a game that is not on this list, your vote is void. If you still want to have your vote counted, you can make a new vote directly under your previous one. I will let this stand for a while, because this episode will be up pretty close to my little travel. Where I will see the ocean. Even if it's just the Baltic Sea, I will see the ocean.
Yay!
Modest type. If you want to have your vote counted, if your vote is void because you voted for a game that is not on the list, directly reply to this to that vote you had before. If you want to vote for another game because you don't want, for example, vote for Shadowrun Returns but for Shadowrun Dragonfall, also reply to yourself on that one vote. Important. I don't want a million comments saying, I vote for this, no, I vote for this, no, I vote for this. Have it at least organized if you want to do that. That's the least you can do. I don't want to have to go out and search for the votes through the comment section of the video itself. Be quiet out there. Don't like the system? Tough luck, that is a system now. It's easier on me, and I don't want to use straw balls for that. Because I doubt I can have a big enough straw ball. I really, really doubt that. Come on. Wood! Oh, the wood. What? How many? Oh! One more, please. Ooh, apple. Yum, 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 yum. Eat your fruit and vegetables. They're important. So, pretty clean again. Now you. I could tell my preferences now. And probably foil the vote. But hey, I still have some time. I still have some time. And you grow faster, grow a lot. Damn, I knew I forgot something there. Well. I have an axe. Oh dear. Let's start filling then. Jesus. And yes, 3 PM. And somewhere telephone is ringing. Not in my house, I think, but I can still hear it. Say house. It's more like apartment slash flat, but hey. Again, cast down your vote. We have only two. One for the round table, one for the fireplace. Cast your vote down in the comments below. And now, I will time travel back to episode 12. See you all in the past of the past. Good night, and sleep well.